So something I'm getting a lot of use out of Rome for lately is reading books. Given the quarantine, I've been reading a lot more lately, and I'm finding Rome to be a great way to help me keep track of what I want to read next and what I've read and get more value out of what I do. So I'll show you quickly here how I do that. So suppose I hear from someone today, I should read Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl. Good book. So I could say, you know, Steve, I'll often tag people in there, you know, with their name, Steve Smith, whatever, you know, suggested I read Man's Search for Meaning. Okay. What I want to do, again, the Steve Smith tag is all about Steve. That's for a different topic, but Man's Search for Meaning is a book I should read. So I want to click in there, even if I'm not planning to read it right now, and add a few things to it. So we'll click into it. I have my metadata page that I've shown in a different video, but you can just shift click and open that up. And in here is books. So I'll just copy that all into the top of the book thing for a couple reasons. One, I want to start making a page for like Viktor Frankl, you know, whatever I want to do there. Reading status is an important one. I have a hashtag I use on mine called to read. For anything I want to read, I put there. When I'm done, I just change it to just a plain finished. I don't need a tag for that. I guess I could maybe, but we'll leave it at to read for now. Date finishes blank. Why is an important one though? Because when I look at my list of books I want to read, and I struggled with this for years, I download books to Kindle, and then when it came time to read the next book, I ask, why do I have this book in here? What made me want to read that? So I can put in here, I can say, you know, Steve Smith suggested it because, you know, whatever. You can put in your reasons for why Steve suggested it. And then any other tags you might want to put, and the notes are intended for afterward. Again, the why in this case doesn't matter as much because it pulls in the reference for it, but you may want to put more context around that there. Then also in my personal Rome, I have this to read. I keep it starred on the side there. So whenever I want to read a book, I can click on to read and it'll have a bunch of linked references, only ones that I still need to read. Again, once I'm finished, I get rid of that to read tag and this cleans up. And so I can kind of go through the list, see what's in there, kind of click through, see why I chose to read it. It takes a couple minutes, but if I'm going to spend hours reading a book, I'll spend a few minutes to research why. But let's say now we finished this book. So go into Man's Search for Meaning, and we'll say it is finished here. Finished. And the date finished was today. Oops, if I can spell. There's that. And then notes. I have a whole bunch of notes, and these are actually the notes from my book. I'll go ahead and paste them in here. I'll indent them from Kindle. I highlight. So then afterward, I pull all of my Kindle highlights in and then spend some time going through linking different folks, if it's names or other lessons, or he mentioned death in Tehran a few times. So I thought it was worth noting, and I actually went into, in my personal one, into death in Tehran and showed the story of that in there. So lots of cool stuff. I highlighted some quotes and different things here, but the beautiful thing is now this is finished. So if I go to my to read list, it's no longer there. In theory, this has a bunch of other books in there to read, but it makes it very easy just to know what I want to read. But then also this book is kind of floating around now. It's got tags everywhere with different things. So it's bound to come up. Again, kind of the beauty of Rome is that things will come up, you know, on their own. So if I somewhere else end up reading about Freud, you know, go into that page, you know, from somewhere else, like, oh yeah, he was in Man's Search for Meaning, and it may lead me back to that. But works well for that kind of thing. So that's basically how I handle my books. The one other thing I do lately, maybe not a great example here, but instead of this, often at the end of each day, I'll have a few different meta things I'll add in. I'll add exercise, and so I might put, like, ran, you know, 3 miles, whatever. But I also have a reading one. And so I could say started or continued or whatever, Man's Search for Meaning. And so the cool thing there is over time, if it takes you, you know, a week or two to finish a book, when you go back into it, you're able to see at the bottom when you started, when you worked on it, and all the different dates will kind of show up below that for the section of time that you spent reading it. So it's kind of nice just to go back and see, okay, I read that over the course of 10 different sessions or 3 different sessions, and years from now you can go back and say, oh, I started it and finished it in April of 2020, you know, whatever you want to do there. Makes it nice. And then also it's kind of good for your daily notes. If you use it as kind of a journal, you can go back and say, oh, that day I was reading that book, and you know, it's kind of nice. But again, for me, the main purpose of this is to get the notes in here in a good way, which Rome is so good at. But then in my case, to make this to read list more useful. So when I finish a book, I can come in and see what I have here to read and then help, you know, decide which one is worth reading based on the notes I left for it before. Because even when Steve suggests a book, as you saw, it takes just a minute just to set up that quick stuff, put in a few notes about why I want to read it, which I'll be very thankful for in 2 months or so when I come back to my to read list and dig out an old reference I had in here and can quickly remember why I had put it in there in the first place. So hope that's helpful.